गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू क्लास 12 बायोलॉजी क्लास। फिफ्थ यूनिट इज कंटिन्यू, चैप्टर 13 ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड पॉपुलेशन। टॉपिक इज इकोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ प्लांट्स। वाटर इज वेरी एसेंशियल फॉर लाइफ ऑफ प्लांट्स बिकॉज इट इज नेसेसरी फॉर द ग्रोथ, रिप्रोडक्शन एंड फिजिकल फंक्शंस। ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ स्पेसिफिक रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ वाटर फॉर प्लांट ग्रोथ, बर्मिंग डिवाइडेड प्लांट इंटू थ्री ग्रुप्स। दे आर द हाइड्रोफाइट्स विच रिक्वायर मोर अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर, मेसोफाइट्स एंड जीरोफाइट्स। सिंपर 1903 डिवाइडेड प्लांट इंटू फोर ग्रुप ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर वाटर रिक्वायरमेंट एंड नेचर ऑफ इट्स अवेलेबिलिटी। दे आर हाइड्रोफाइट, जीरोफाइट, हेलोफाइट और मैंग्रोव प्लांट्स एंड मेसोफाइट्स। बिसाइड दीज थ्री कैटेगरीज, वन फोर कैटेगरीज इज एडेड। हेलोफाइट्स और मैंग्रोव प्लांट्स आर साल्ट लविंग प्लांट्स, प्लांट ग्रोइंग इन हाई साल्टी सॉइल or the hylophytes. First we describe hydrophytes. Hydrophytes are the group of plants that grow in water either partly or wholly submerged or in extremely bed soil. Hydrophytes are very common in lake, pond, spring, river, canals, streams, irrigation channels, swamps. Hydrophytes are simply called aquatic plants. Characteristic features of hydrophytes: important characteristic feature of hydrophytic plants are cuticle is either absent or very thinly deposited on the epidermis because whole plant body is absorptive in nature in aquatic plants, therefore they don't contain cuticles. Usually stomata are absent, if present they are non-functional. Many air chamber are large intracellular spaces are present inside the plant body of hydrophytes. These air chambers or air spaces help them to floating in the water. The whole body of the plants help in the absorption of water and minerals. Root system is poorly developed and usually non-branched or less branched. Some hydrophytes like Bolpia, it lacks roots. Mechanical tissue are less distributed. Mechanical tissue is xylem. Because the whole plant body absorbs mineral and water, therefore there is no need of translocation of mineral and water. Therefore, xylem tissue or mechanical tissue is poorly developed. Vascular tissue are either absent or feebly developed in the case of hydrophytes. Vascular tissue of plants are xylem and phloem. Xylem conduct mineral and water and phloem conduct organic food materials. Classification of aquatic plants on the basis of their habitat, on the basis of relationship between aquatic plants and their aquatic habitat, hydrophytes are classified into four groups. Submerged plants, the plants which are completely embedded inside the waters. Floating plants, which float on water surface. amphibious plants, which can survive both in water and soil, and marshy plants, which are growing in marshy places or in the mud. Submerged plants may be rooted submerged or free floating submerged plants. Rooted or floating submerged floating plants are also free floatings and rooted floatings. Submerged hydrophytic plants. These are rooted hydrophytic plants of shallow region, and whole or maximum portion of plant body are found deep into water. They are divided into two groups: rooted submerged plants. These plants are completely submerged in water and are fixed in soil by their roots. For example, Potamogetons, Nitalia, Bellisneria, floating submerged plants. These plants are submerged in water but are not fixed in soil by their root systems. Example, Hydrilla. Floating plants. These plants float on the surface or slightly below the surface of water, are called floating hydrophytes. These specific group of plants are in contact with both water and air. They are also categorized into two categories: free floating plants. This type of floating hydrophytes are not found attached to the soil. They float on the surface of water. They grow in large number in ponds and pools. They grow collectively. The aggregation of such plants makes the water surface completely invisible. Some farms have very large leaves which rise above in the air, but some free floating farms may be a small leaf. Examples are Balfia, Lemna, Pistia, Epornia, Azolla, Salvinia, Spirodella, etc. Rooted floating plants. Such category of aquatic plants are rooted in mud but possesses floating leaves. They normally grow in the shallow region of water system like pond, tank, lake. Their roots are dipped into the mud. Example, Juicia, Nymphia, Trapa, Victoria regia, etc. Amphibious plants. Some plants are adapted to both aquatic and terrestrial mode of life. These are called amphibious plants. They grow in shallow waters or muddy situation. Root and some part of stem of these plants are found submerged in waters or buried in mud, but some portion of stem, branches, leaves, inflorescence are found above the surface of water, or they may spread over the land. Example, Ranunculus, Sagittaria, Monocaris, Limnophila, etc. Fourth category of aquatic or hydrophytes is marshy plants. Marshy plants are also categorized as amphibian plant, but in these plants the shoots are completely exposed to air as in land, but the roots are buried in water, large soils or mud. Example, Cypress, Scirpus, Rheumax, Polygonum, Typha, etc. Hydrophytic adaptations in aquatic plants. Such changes which enable the hydrophytic plants to withstand the atrocities of environment and utilize it to their maximum benefit are known as hydrophytic adaptations or hydrophytic responses. Plants growing in water or water-rich substratum require abundance of water to complete their life cycles and so three types of adaptations, morphological adaptations or responses, anatomical and physiological responses or adaptations. Morphological adaptations are responses, adaptation in root, in which way their roots are adapted for aquatic mode of life. The root system is feebly developed and unbranched. Their root system is poorly developed because whole plant body is absorptive in nature. Main function of root is absorption of water and minerals, but in aquatic plants, whole plant body is absorptive in nature, therefore their roots are poorly developed. Some floating plants like Bulbia, Utricularia, etc., and some submerged plants like Keratophyllum, roots are absent in these plants. Root hair are absent except rooted floating hydrophytes. In most of hydrophytes, roots are meaningless, as the entire surface of plant body is in direct contact with water and act as absorptive surface. This may probably be the reason why rooted hydrophytes are reduced or absent. True root cap are absent in some free floating hydrophytes, and in lieu of that, they develop root pocket or root sheath which protect their tip from injury. If roots are present, they are always of adventitious type like Nymphaea, Nelumbo, etc. In Yuccia, modified spongy, negative geotropic, floating roots are present which provide buoyancy to the plants and also do the job of gaseous exchange. They help the plants to float on the waters and also exchange oxygen and carbon dioxide between environment and plant body. Adaptation in stem in submerged hydrophytes like hydrilla, podmogeton, etc., stems are long, slender and flexible. In free floating hydrophytes, stems are modified as thick, stout, stoloniferous or as offset and occurs horizontal on the water surface. It bears vegetative bud at their apex and help in vegetative propagation. In rooted floating hydrophytes or rooted submerged hydrophytes or in marshy plants, a stem may be modified as runner or rhizome. A stem may be modified as runner, stolon, tuber to perform vegetative propagations effectively. Usually, stems are of perennial natures, means they grow year after year. Morphological adaptation in leaves. Leaves are thin, long, ribbon shaped in the submerged forms. For example, Balaesneria, Teratophyllum, etc., or they are finely dissected as found in Ranunculus aquaticus. In rooted floating plants like Nymphaea, Nelumbo, etc., petiole of leaves show indefinite power of growth and they keep the lamina of leaf always on the surface of water. Their petiole or stalk of leaf is 2 months long, which brings the leaves outside from water into the air. in tree pollinating plants like Eugenia, Tropha, the petiole become swollen and develop a sponginess which keep the plants afloat, which help the plants floating in the water. They contain parenchymatous tissue filled with air and help in buoyancy in the waters. Occurrence of two or more than two different type of leaves in a plant is called heterophylly. Example, Limnophila, Heterophylla, Sagittaria, Ranunculus, Equitalis, etc. They bear leaves of many types, submerged leaves, floating leaves, aerial leaves, linear ribbon-shaped leaves or dissected leaves. Floating leaves are entire and lobed. The broad leaves found on the surface of water transpire actively and regulate the hydrostatic pressure in the plant body. The submerged leaves act as water absorbing organ. Heterophily is also associated with quantitative reduction in transpirations. In the amphibious or marshy plants, leaves that are exposed to air show typical mesophytic features. They are leathery and more tough than the submerged and floating hydrophytes. Anatomical responses are anatomical adaptations. Some changes are found in their anatomy also. These adaptations may be cuticle is totally lacking in submerged form of hydrophytes and their whole plant body act as an organ of absorption or water and nutrients. Cuticle is made up of fat and polysaccharides, which is insulator for exchange of molecules. Therefore, it is absent in hydrophytic plants because their whole body act as absorbing organs. Cuticle may be present in the form of very thin layer on the surface of parts of floating and amphibious hydrophytes which are exposed to atmospheres. Epidermis is made up of cells which extremely thin cellulose ball of epidermal cells which facilitates the absorption process. Chlorophyll are present in epidermis. In mesophytic or terrestrial plants, chlorophyll is present on mesophyll cells, but in hydrophytes, it is present in epidermal cells or epidermis. Intercellular air spaces or air cavities more prominently occurs in submerged leaves and stems and other part of hydrophytes. These parenchyma provide buoyancy and mechanical support to aquatic plants. CO2 present in the air chamber is used up in the photosynthesis, and oxygen produced in the process of photosynthesis used in respiration process. Stomata are completely absent in submerged hydrophytes or submerged parts. If present, they are non-functional. In the floating form of hydrophytes, stomata develop in very limited number and are confined only to the upper surface because their lower surface remain in contact with water. Vascular tissue is poorly developed in submerged form in comparison to emergent form of hydrophytes. In the vascular system, xylem show greatest reduction. In some cases, it consists of only a few tracheids, while in submerged forms, xylem elements are not at all developed. Some aquatic plants like hydrilla, potmegalton, however, show a lacuna in the center at the place of xylem and resemble typical air chamber. In phloem, phloem parenchyma is extensively developed. Some sort of mechanical tissue are prevalent in emergent forms and rooted floating hydrophytes with the large leaves, for example in water lily, lotus and some other plants. A special type of star-shaped lignified cells called sterile scleroids develop which give mechanical support to the plants. Mechanical tissue are completely absent in submerged forms like hydrilla, potmegalton, teratophyllum, ट्यूट्रिकुल एरिया एक्सेट्रा। दिस कंडीशन अलाउ इजी बेंडिंग ऑफ द प्लांट पार्ट अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ वाटर करेंट्स। हाइड्रोफाइट्स सेक्रेट म्यूसिलेजनस सब्सटेंस ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ देयर पार्ट विच प्रोवाइड प्रोटेक्शन अगेंस्ट इंजरीज एंड इफेक्ट ऑफ वाटर करेंट। इट ऑल्सो हेल्प इन मूवमेंट विथ वाटर करेंट्स। सेकेंडरी ग्रोथ आर लेकिंग इन हाइड्रोफाइट्स। इन लीव्स देयर इज पुअर डिफरेंटिएशन बिटवीन स्पंजी एंड पॉलीसेट टिश्यू। इन प्लांट्स टू टाइप ऑफ ग्रोथ आर फाउंड। प्राइमरी ग्रोथ मीन ग्रोथ इन लेंथ इज कॉल्ड प्राइमरी ग्रोथ एंड ग्रोथ इन विड्थ इज कॉल्ड सेकेंडरी ग्रोथ। फिजियोलॉजिकल एडेप्टेशन इन हाइड्रोफाइटिक और एक्वेटिक प्लांट्स। दीज फिजियोलॉजिकल एडेप्टेशन आर हाइड्रोफाइट शो लो ऑस्मोटिक कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ सेल से ऑस्मोटिक कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ सेल शेप इज इक्वल और स्लाइटली हायर देन दैट ऑफ द हैबिटेट वाटर। सम हाइड्रोफाइट पासेसेस हाइड्रोथोर्स वाटर स्टोमेटा। इन फ्लोएटिंग हाइड्रोफाइट्स विच रिड्यूस द एक्सेसिव अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर प्रेजेंट इन द प्लांट बॉडी ऑफ द हाइड्रोफाइट अबाउट ऑस्मोटिक कंसंट्रेशन। Hydrothorus, we have to read in the plant physiology chapters. The gases are exchanged from water through surface cells. Some CO2 evolved during respiration is stored in the air spaces, which is consumed during photosynthesis, and oxygen evolved in photosynthesis is used in respirations. Mucilage is the secretion of mucilage cells and mucilage canals around the body of hydrophytes provide protection against friction, desiccation, decaying and microbial injuries. Flowering and fruiting is comparatively poor. They are adapted more for vegetative propagation. Whole body of plant act as an absorbing area for the absorption of nutrients. There is no transpiration from the submerged hydrophytes. However, emergent plants are free floating hydrophytes have excessive rate of transpiration. Xerophytes places where available water is not present in adequate quantity are termed as xeric habitat. And if the soil is provided with very low content of water and the climate is dry, the habitat is called physically dry. Plants growing in dry habitats are in habitat where water is unfit for absorption, such as saline waters or physiological dry, are called xerophytes. In simpler words, plants growing in area where the availability of water to plant is low are called xerophytes. Dubenmayer 1959 defined xerophytes as plants which grow on substrata that usually become depleted of growth water to a depth of at least 2 decimeters during normal season. According to Barron 1967, the plants which are better adapted to grow in dry habitats are called xerophytes. Factors responsible for xerophytism: non-availability of water in the soil, occurrence of high temperature, strong light intensity, high wind velocity, and high rate of evaporation in the habitat. Low water supply to the plants and high rate of transpiration lead to xerophytic habits. The condition of physiological dryness, that is, available water is too salty or too acidic, which cannot be utilized by plant. Also, water is available, but it is not used by plants. Such condition is called physiological dryness. High water lodging around the root of plants, occurrence of sandy or rocky soil. Low precipitation आर लो रेनफॉल एरिया, जीरोफाइटिज मीन डिटरमाइंड बाई डिजर्ट और सेमी डिजर्ट रीजन, लो ह्यूमिडिटी एंड हाई टेम्परेचर। मेन जेरिक हैबिटेट्स places where available water is not present in adequate quantity are termed as xeric habitats. There are three type of dry habitats: physically dry habitats, physically dry habitats have relatively dry climate and extremely dry soil, desert and regions, rock surface, wasteland are the common example for physically dry habitats. The rainfall of this region is very low, soil is porous and sandy and cannot retain water to any appreciable extent. Atmospheric temperature become as high as 58 degree centigrade during the daytime and similarly soil temperatures may reach up to 65 degree centigrade with dry wind determine acute xerophile. Physiologically dry, physiologically dry habitats have bad climate and moist soil, but the water present in the soil cannot be used by plants directly. This difficulty may be due to high acidity or alkalinity of soil water, extremely low temperatures, that is cold desert also causes physiological dryness. Physiological dryness is sometimes also seen in otherwise normal situations because of the deficiency of some essential minerals like zinc, molybdenum, etc. Plants growing in physiologically dry area are often known as physiological xerophytes. And third type is both physical and physiological. Physical and physiological dry soil or dry climate habitat where dryness is caused by both actual deficiency of water as well as inability of plants to absorb water due to physiological reasons. Rocky slope of high mountains are the good example of such type of habitat. The classification of xerophytes. Classification of xerophytes on the basis of morphology, physiology and water storage adaptations or adaptabilities, xerophytes can be categorized into three types: ephemeral or drought escaping plants, ephemerals or short-lived, ephemerals or short-lived plants that survive in the form of seed with thick and hard seed coat and in the form of fruit with thick pericarp during extremely dry season. Plants including under these types are mostly short-living annual, which complete their life cycle within 6 to 9 weeks before the advent of dry seasons. means they escape themselves from the dry season. Since this sort of life cycle help the plants to escape from extremely dry conditions, these plants are called drought escaping plants or ephemerals. Examples: Argemone mexicana, Solanum xanthocarpum, Tribulus terrestris, Euphorbia prostrata, etc. Succulent xerophytes are drought resistant xerophytes. Succulent or drought resistance, those plants which grow in xeric habitat and possess a high water storage region of inner parenchymatous tissue are called succulent plants. The regions which have high water holding capacity are well developed and modified as glacial structures, whereas other organs are greatly reduced. Examples: aloe vera, agave, cactus, opuntia, etc. Third type is non-succulent perennials or drought enduring xerophytes. This type of plants require a small quantity of water for their survival. They have some adaptation to reduce water loss with a view of conserving internal water. These plants possess the capacity to tolerate drought by having morphological, anatomical and physiological characteristics and hence called drought enduring plants. They are also called true xerophytes or eugerophytes. Example: Solanum, Sarampelus, Econops, Echinetus, Casuarina, Calotropis, Nerium, Salvadora, Gigipas, etc. Adaptation in xerophytes.